Welcome to the video lectures on course Radiation and Microwave Technique. Here we are going through the unit number 2, that is radiating elements and arrays. From the previous lecture, what we have started with unit 2 is the analysis of the dipole antennas, and the analysis of infinitesimal dipole or the Hertzian dipole antenna has been completed. And now we will move to the analysis of the small dipole antenna. So the contents of today's lecture are the analysis of the small dipole antenna. Let's see what are the content that will be completed in this video lecture. Learning outcomes: small dipole antenna parameters like radiated field, radiation intensity and directivity, maximum effective aperture, radiation resistance, radiation pattern. Coming to the learning outcome, after completion of this lecture, students will be able to understand as well as they will be able to analyze different parameters of small dipole antenna like radiated field, radiation intensity and directivity, maximum effective aperture, radiation resistance, radiation pattern of the small dipole antenna. So before starting with the analysis of this small dipole antenna, we will see what is the small dipole antenna. You know, small dipole antenna is again the type of wire antenna which is having the length which is very smaller, which is in between lambda by 10 to lambda by 50. So consider now for the analysis of this small dipole antenna, the antenna is placed along the Z axis and it is placed symmetrically. You can see it is placed on the Z axis and it is placed symmetrically. You can see the L, this length is total L, and from the point of the origin it is L by 2, and below the point of origin it is L by 2. So the total length of dipole antenna is L, and the current is not assumed to be zero over here. The dipole antenna length is smaller, so there will be the triangular current distribution. It will be zero at this point. It will be zero at both the ends, and we will get the maximum current at the center. Now, as the length of the antenna, dipole antenna, it increases, if it is, for example, it is equal to lambda by 2, this variation will not be triangular. It will be a perfect sinusoidal waveform. As this current will satisfy the boundary condition of a sinusoidal waveform, that is, it will be 0 coming to maxima and again going to 0, and again in the next half cycle 0, maxima and again to 0. So in this case of small dipole antenna, as it is very small, so any sinusoidal distribution for the short distance can be approximated as the triangular distribution. So here the average value of the current, it will be I0/2. So from here, what we can do is, as we have assumed that the small dipole antenna has triangular current distribution, the current can be written as IE of X dash, Y dash, Z dash. These are the points of origin, equal to AZ bar I naught 1 minus 2 by L Z dash, which is in between Z dash from L by 2 to 0, that is above the origin, and AZ bar I naught 1 plus 2 by L Z dash from Z dash ranging from 0 to minus L by 2, which is below the origin. So from this we know, from the current we can write the magnetic vector potential as A, can be written as A x comma y comma z equal to mu upon 4 pi A z bar integration of I e, that is divided into two parts, from minus L by 2 to 0 I naught 1 plus 2 by L z dash e raised to minus j k r upon r d z dash, plus AZ bar integration from 0 to L by 2 I naught 1 minus 2 by L Z dash e raised to minus JKR upon R DZ dash. So what we are doing over here is we are taking the average of the length. So we can assume the same that what we have done for the infinitesimal dipole, except now here this current I naught will become I naught by 2, which is the average value of the triangular distribution. So we can say that this magnetic vector potential Az is equal to Az bar into Az, which is equal to the half of that of the magnetic vector potential of the infinitesimal dipole antenna. We know the infinitesimal dipole antenna's magnetic vector potential A is equal to Az bar mu I naught L e raised to minus jkr upon 4 pi r. So in this case of small dipole antenna, it will be half of that of the infinitesimal dipole. So it is equal to Az bar half of mu I naught L e raised to minus jkr upon 4 pi r. So this is the equation of magnetic vector potential. So for calculating the electric field and the magnetic field, this far field region is the region of most practical interest. Since the vector magnetic potential A for the triangular current distribution is one half of the vector magnetic potential A for the constant or the uniform current distribution, that is in the case of infinitesimal dipole, so the corresponding field will also be one half of that of the fields with the uniform current distribution, that is in the case of the Hertzian or the infinitesimal dipole. So we can write the electric field and the magnetic field as the half of the magnetic and the electric field in the case of infinitesimal dipole. So here just it was 4 pi r, so multiplying with 1 by 2 has become 8 pi r. Er, E phi, HR, H theta, they are equal to 0, and H phi is again multiplying with 1 by 2, it becomes this 8 pi r. So now coming to the different parameters of dipole antenna, like radiation intensity, directivity, effective aperture area and radiation resistance, we will see this one by one. Since the directivity of the antenna, it is controlled by the relative shape of the field or the power pattern. The directivity and the maximum effective area of this antenna, they are same as that of the constant current distribution. So the maximum radiation intensity is same as that of the infinitesimal dipole antenna, which is equal to umax equal to eta by 2 k I naught L upon 4 pi r whole bracket square. Similarly, the directivity is also same, d naught equal to 4 pi, umax upon radiated power is equal to 3 by 2. And the maximum effective area is AEM equal to lambda square by 4 pi into d naught, which is equal to 3 pi square upon 8 pi. Now coming to the radiation resistance of a small dipole antenna, this radiation resistance, it is not the physical quantity, it is the representation of the radiated power considered to be the loss power from the circuit point of view. We know the radiation resistance is given as twice of radiated power divided mod of I naught square. In this case, this I naught is as we are having triangular current distribution, this I naught is I naught divided by 2. So in the case of this small dipole antenna, the radiation resistance it will be 1/4 times that of the radiation resistance of the infinitesimal dipole. As if we put here I naught divided by 2, it will be I naught square by 4. That indicates that the radiation resistance will become 1/4 time that of the radiation resistance of the infinitesimal dipole. The radiation resistance of infinitesimal dipole antenna is 4 pi square L by lambda whole bracket square. So multiplying it with 1 by 4, we will get radiation resistance of small dipole antenna, which is denoted with RR equal to 2 pi square L by lambda whole bracket square. So coming to the radiation pattern, which is the last part of this video lecture, the radiation pattern is again same as that of the infinitesimal dipole or the Hertzian dipole. You can see it is having the radiation equal in this direction, and at this center it becomes zero and it goes on increasing till this point. Similar on this side also. So this radiation pattern is more similar to that of the omnidirectional antenna, that is radiating in one plane. So now here we have completed with all the contents of this video lecture. We will summarize that we started with what is the small dipole antenna. Small dipole antenna is the dipole antenna having length in between lambda by 10 to lambda by 50, and we have calculated the electric field and the magnetic field of the small dipole antenna, which is one half of that of the infinitesimal dipole antenna in the far field region. Then we have seen the directivity and the radiation intensity and the effective area of small dipole antenna. They remain same as that of the infinitesimal dipole antenna. And we have also calculated the radiation resistance. Radiation resistance is 1/4 times that of the radiation resistance of the Hertzian dipole antenna. And at last we saw the radiation pattern of this antenna, which is same as that of the Hertzian dipole. It is having omnidirectional radiation pattern. Thank you.